Proposals.
It does look great. Yeah. I'll get married
up here. Outside these fronts stands the medieval Chateau de Rosière. Dating to the 13th century, a set of the 130-acre wooden estate. His towers once warded off invaders. But 3 years ago, yoga teacher and writer Amy and husband Mark, a French farmer, decided to take the place off. Estate as a theme for the mezzanine level in the bar.
You can start to see the turret light, which I really feel
up. And the royal windows for the cafe have the stone wall pointed with traditional mortar.
They use lime and it comes up really neat.
As it will be months before work is finished, Amy's turning her attention to landscaping. Meditation area high up on the 130-acre estate overlooking the chateau. That means not heavy 20 minutes of heavy terrain to clear a part of the least accessible and rather overgrown section of the land. Rather than do that, he's told Amy into that investment. Meditation space will all be down tomorrow. At least that's the plan.
The difficulty now will be getting me to refocus on the work that he's doing and not finding an excuse to go out of his court.
That's really good fun.
Mark's keeping on track with the project and using the port car to reach the ground that needs clearance. Start strewing to clear away enough of the dense vegetation to make way for group seating.
These are very spacious and have the most horrible thing you can get to clear.
It's a tough job, made even tougher by the summer heat.
It's 10 past 9. It's already horribly hot.
creeping on the larger branches.
It's attached. It's of course now.
After a few hours of hard work by man and machine, the meditation clearing is starting to take shape.
But then we installed the benches and made it nice and tidy.
There may still be lots to do, but who wouldn't feel zen looking at that view? It's curtains for mom and daughter. Leah's fiancé Luke, a plumber by trade, is working on some props to set the stage.
I lost my last candle of a copper from the big box. Just what basically my consequence of this one that I made earlier. A few bells on it, and it should look.
In front of the pentagon, octagon, hexagon. Mum,
I'm not
very much. Casual scatter, yeah? It literally is a transformed space that does have a thing to feel about it.
Fingers crossed into the couple's face. Build the shepherd's reputation for future bookings. Nearly 300 miles southwest, a chateau level moves on. After clearing the riverside for their luxury clubbing area, Ben and Billy now need to construct the flipping pontoon.
Oh, wow, it's a treasure trove in here, isn't it?
To keep the cost down, most of the materials from the shattered woodshed.
A living stay, John.
Yeah.
These are various pallets from having tiles delivered. We can if we have two exactly the same size.
They've come up with a plan to use two wooden pallets as the frame of the pontoon. Now they want something to keep it afloat.
I was chatting to a guest this morning. He reckons 1 litre of polystyrene will hold first time I'm here. This is left over from the cancer station in the library. And what we can do is cut it into strips that fit exactly inside the post. So we use the pad as a frame. We could screw two pallets together and then actually go and buy some garden decking pallet that's all wood treated and actually then apply the whole thing on timber.
Right, so that will look smart even though it's just, upcycled junk.
Upcycled junk, yeah. Packing the pallets with raw stone will make them buoyant. We need to measure up outside so Ben can calculate if the poultry will float with people on it.
Roughly 173 kilograms. Okay.
Yeah, that would be alright.
Yeah, that's two people.
Next job is cutting the polystyrene to fit inside the pallets.
Do you know what though? Can we be somewhere else? There's a sound.
You going to be
Ben saws the polystyrene to size, safely out of Billy's earshot. After putting everything together to test it fits, he's come up with another idea to make sure the platform stays afloat.
We still needed to think of some buoyancy.
Yeah.
So these are some fenders we used to have on our boat. So they'll be adding additional buoyancy. We can put two either side.
Right. Probably the most elegant as well, I have to say. Oh, that's going to be so nice. I think it looks so smart already. I think guests are going to love it as well. I think they're really going to love it.
Yeah, good.
I love it. Fantastic.
Ben's got Billy's seal of approval. But he still needs to screw the whole thing together and see how it fares on its maiden voyage before they'll know if this project holds water. Looking at her wedding business, sees no half measures for Wendy. This is what I've been lying at his house. For the last century, Mark's now created a clearing for a meditation space where Amy will host their first group today.
Okay, just happy with that.
Amy has invited her local hiking group to take part in a trial run, so they can start taking more bookings soon to offset some of the build costs of the retreat. She still needs to complete copy seating to use up in the clearing.
I'm going to attempt to make meditation cushions so that people can sit on the logs.
Amy needs to sew and stuff 7 cushions.
I've got one bit of cheer sheet on how to use a sewing machine. This is the internet job all the way.
The idea is that Amy will take a new group into a place of calm relaxation. So Amy needs to keep any beginner's nerves in check and avoid getting stressed.
They're going to be big squishy things people sit on, so hopefully it's not going to be too noticeable.
Mark has other ideas on how to add relaxation to the evening.
So what will we do?
Amy's brief for group refreshment is hot chocolate. But Mark's mulled that over and come up with a plan of his own.
And if you try to arrange to make sure it's served and something good.
He hopes spiced wine will give the guests a more warm option.
That's not bad. Save you on the bottle. And if you try this one, that's